YouTube. I recently got a lot of messages about my drum set and everything, and I was supposed to do this a long time ago, so I'm just gonna go ahead with it and talk about my drum set. Alright, I have two drum sets. I just bought my second drum set, but I'm gonna talk about the drum set that y'all probably are used to seeing is my Red Yamaha Stage Custom Advantage. I think I got this in 2005 when they first started doing the split lugs instead of the tube high tension lugs that Yamaha is known to have when they're recording customs. I'm using a Stage Custom Advantage drum kit. Here's the setup. It's a 8-inch tom, 10-inch tom, 12-inch tom, 14-inch tom, and my snare drums vary. Alright, this drum kit is my workhorse. I had this drum kit since my freshman year of high school. I had a drum set, my first drum set was a blue Sunlight drum set, and I had that since I think seventh grade. So actually I got this Yamaha kit in middle school, I think seventh or eighth grade. So I had this drum kit for a long time. So for those people who think I got money, I don't. I'm able to tune drum kits, bro. That's all. Drum heads for the Yamaha kit, they vary on how money flows. So I might have a whole set of Evans drum heads with a Remo bass drum head, or a whole set of Remos that's clear and coded. So it really doesn't matter, but if you really want to know specifics, right now on my current Yamaha set, as of, gotta check the date, November 22nd, 2018, I have really old Remo pinstripe head. On my 10, 12, and 14 inch, I'm talking about the tops, I have Remo Emperors. And on my 16, I have a 16 inch floor tom that my school gave to me. It's a Sunlight Burgundy floor tom. I have coated Emperor. And on the bass drum, on the Yamaha bass drum, on the batter side, I have a smooth white Power Stroke 3. On the front, I have a Power Stroke, I think it's a resonant, black resonant with a hole in it. So that's pretty much my Yamaha. My Gretsches, I never really had a chance to change the heads. I bought the Gretsches used. I still have the price tag on the bass drum. That's how I am. When I buy big things, I keep, if it's optional, I keep the price tag on there. So I paid, $400, but some friends of mine helped me out, so I only had to pay like, $350. I paid like $350 for this Gretsch kit, which used, and I really want to slap the last owner of this Gretsch kit, because it's a Gretsch pedal and a jazz kit, and it was tuned like my, it was tried to be tuned like my normal Yamaha. You can't tune jazz kits, bebop kits low. But anyway, this kit sounds really good. The bass drum sounds, when you muffle it, it sounds really beefy, even though it's an 18-inch bass drum. And the sizes are a 12-inch tom, 14-inch tom, an 18-inch bass drum. And the snare drum varies, but this kit came with the snare drum. It came with a 14x5.5 Catalina jazz snare drum. The shells are mahogany, so they sound really, really warm. I love them. Sometimes I bring out the whole four piece. Sometimes I add an extra floor time or a time for my Yamahas. I want to buy a remote bass drum pedal and bust out a Dave Weckl setup. You know, have my 18-inch bass drum that's like for the quiet stuff and the 22-inch for the loud stuff. But I don't have money on that. Alright, folks. I hope you enjoyed the video. And remember, give a little bit of advice. Remember, it's not like the instrument doesn't play you. You play the instrument. You might have a signature Gibson guitar, but you're not gonna sound like Les Paul. It's what you put in the instrument, not the gear. All right. All right. My next few videos are gonna be about my recording gear, my hardware and stuff. So be on the lookout for that. All right, I'm out. I'm gonna watch Janet Jackson upstairs because her band is all phenomenal. All right. I'm out.